Hey VIP, this is Chris from Brigandi Coins and Collectibles here in New York City. This week's email, we are going to be featuring some New York Knicks memorabilia, of course, because they have finally reached the playoffs since the first time since 2013. They have the number 4 seed in the East and in New York. Obviously, we're sports fans. This is a big deal for us. And the last time this happened, that they actually won the World Championship, was in 1970 and 1973. And that's the memorabilia I want to talk about today. So the first item here is a 1973 New York Knicks team signed basketball. All the big guys are here. I'll kind of flip it around, but we have Jerry Lucas, Willis Reed, the coach, Red Holtzman, I'll flip them around that way. Dave DeBuscher, Walt Frazier, Phil Jackson. So there's a ton of autographs here. So if you're a big Knicks fan, especially vintage, this is just, one of those really cool pieces to own. I also have two more pieces I want to show you on the walls here. We have a lithograph here. So again, we have the signatures of Jerry Lucas, Dave DeBuscher, Willis Reed, Coach Red Holtzman, Earl the Pearl Monroe, Bill Bradley, and Walt Frazier. And those are all excellent signatures, all super high grade there, mint condition. And the piece itself, nice lithograph and high grade, high quality as well. And then let's move over to the third piece. This is my favorite of them all. And this is because it's just something you're not gonna find out there. This is a piece of the original floor from 1970 and 1973, game used court. And it's a huge piece. Typically when you see these pieces, they're a lot smaller. They're like an inch long by a couple inches wide. But this is a huge piece here. And what's great about this is you find them a lot, but you never find them signed. So you got all the guys here. Bill Bradley, Dave DeBuscher, Will Frazier, Willis Reed, Red Holtzman, even the trainer, Danny Whalen. Just a really cool piece, and it's framed and matted with some other unique pieces. Here we have the 73 to 74 program. We have the score sheet from 1970. So, ultimate Knicks piece. If you're a big time Knicks fan, it's definitely a piece you should own. And again, it's pretty rare. It's like a unique piece. Definitely set your collection apart. Now switching off of basketball, we know not everybody's Knicks fans or basketball fans, so we have some cool vintage memorabilia here. Let's start first with the Jackie Robinson autograph. It's a PSA graded mint 9. It's a 3x5 index card, and it's inscribed best wishes. When you're looking for these types of autographs on 3x5s, you always want to make sure that it's a clean piece of paper, which we have here. It just makes the contrast so much better, and the eye appeal is just there. So again, mint 9. Nice blue ink on a white background. And we could frame that really nicely, and we've done that before. We'll put a nice 8x10 picture above it, and just one of those pieces. And Jackie memorabilia has recently really gotten another resurgence, so a lot of Jackie collectors out there. Sticking with baseball, this is going a little more presidential though. This is a Richard Nixon signed book, and as I open it up, you're gonna see why it's baseball related. It has a presidential seal there on the cover. But this is Richard Nixon's all-time baseball team. So it's really cool. I didn't even know he did one of these until I found this piece. And it's just, really cool. So let me just go through a few pages so you get a better idea of it. So here's an introduction, but then he lists out the National League and American League, his all-time teams, both pre-war and post-war teams. As I flip through the pages here, you can kind of see them. And then after he lists them all out, then he goes through and he explains why he picks certain players. It's just a really unique, cool piece of paper, piece of memorabilia, and so much more that it's also autographed as well. So if you like presidential and baseball memorabilia, just a cool, unique piece. Lastly here, this is a really impressive piece, unique for sure. Haven't seen one of these before. General Douglas MacArthur. This is signed on a Japanese 10 pesos note. So this was from World War II. So when the Japanese took over the Philippines and MacArthur was forced to leave, he famously said, "I shall return." And the Japanese, what they did was they put this fiat currency in circulation in the Philippines. And this was the new currency. It really wasn't used at the time. They didn't recognize it. But as Japan was expanding, they wanted to start using their currency. And, you know, obviously if Philippines got taken back over, they would deem it, you know, unusable. So this is one of the pieces of currency. It's a 10 pesos note issued by the Japanese government in the Philippines. And it's ironic, of course, because MacArthur signed it right there across the front. It's PSA slabbed, just a cool note. You know, there's a lot of fakes out there too of the notes, but this is actually a genuine note as well. So you have that going for it too. Just a cool piece of history. And of course, the fact that it's signed by Douglas MacArthur makes it that much better. So I hope you enjoyed this week's video. We show you some Nick stuff, some presidentials, a Jackie Robinson piece, and then of course the World War II MacArthur note. If you have any questions, please reach out to us. Thanks for watching.